my name is Hadass and welcome to Tip Talk. In this chapter, I want to teach you how you can turn any of your designs into a website, including your annual reports. And you can do this entirely in Canva. And the best part is, I'm going to show you how in less than 5 minutes. Are you ready? Let's go.
Congratulations, you finished designing your annual report and now you can publish it as a website. Well, with Canva, it's super easy and I want to show you how. If your annual report looks anything like this on an A4 or any other lettering format, we want to resize it to a website dimension. In order for us to do that, we will just click on resize at the top blue bar, and then we are just going to search for website. Once we find that, we're just going to checkmark and click the website, and we have two options. One is to resize the current design, and the other is copy and resize. I recommend you always pick copy and resize because you don't want to change this current design. So let's keep it safe and choose copy and resize. Then Canva will just give you a new tab with the website dimensions. Now, as you can see, this is not a perfect match. We have to make a few minor adjustments. So this will take only a few minutes of your time and you can make the adjustments needed. So I'll just fast forward and show you what I did. So this is what it looks like after I made a few adjustments. So I have all my pages here. And now the first most important thing you want to do is name your design, your website. So let's just go to the top blue bar and I'm just going to delete this copy of and name my website 2020 annual report. The second thing you want to do is name each and every single page. The name that you give your page is actually going to be the tab on your navigation bar. So you can give it any name you'd like. I'll just name this home. And my second page will be about. And my third one will be performance. Once I did that, I can start publishing my website. Let's go to the top bar. On the right, you have these three dots. I'm going to click on that. And I have my website option. You can also go right ahead and click on publish's website. What you have here is a preview window and you can see exactly how your website is going to be viewed by your audience. We have four options of web styles. Let's click on this menu and go through each and every one. The first one is presentation style. I'll click on open website to show you exactly what it will look like. So it will look like a presentation and my audience will just have to click on this arrow so they can navigate between the pages. Very simple, very easy to use. My second option would be scrolling. Scrolling is a single page site with a parallax effect. Let's take a look at that. And now you can see that I have the same page, but this time I do not have to click but to scroll down. And then I get a preview of all my pages. My third option is called classic navigation. This is actually a combination of multi-page site with a navigation bar. So now you can see the pages and a navigation bar at the top, and these are actually the names that I gave each page. So once I click on home, this is what I see, and I click on about and performance, and then I get all the information. On the left, you can see the name that we gave our design, which is the name of our website. My fourth and last option is standard. Standard is a single page site with a navigation bar, a different kind of combination. Let's click on that and you can see that I still have the navigation bar at the top and this time I can also scroll down so I have both options. So you pick your own option and once you do that, all you have to do is, once you open your website, copy this link up here and then just share it with anyone you'd like. If it's too long, you can shorten it or you can add it as a link to any of your other designs. Now, some things you should know about a website. All your links will be clickable, so don't worry about them. You can add links. Music and videos will play, and there is no need to host it anywhere or have any experience in web developing. How easy was that?
That's it. Thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget to share with us your websites in the comments below, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Wow, thank you, Adas, for these precious tips, and thank you for watching this video until the end. I have two playlists right here for those of you who want to go a bit deeper and keep learning. This one right here is a collection of step-by-step Canva tutorials. And this one gathers all of our Canva Space webinar recordings where Canva experts teach about all sorts of topics.